6150 is used a lot in the substation environment. We noticed that there's increasing popularity of using 6150 because of its flexibility, because of its standardization, also because its fast communication rate. 6150 is built for substation environment and is ideal standard with a set of communication protocols for communicating between IEDs, from IEDs to RTUs or the gateway, or from IEDs to the local HMIs. Our engineers currently working diligently on troubleshooting one of the substations for our clients. We managed to assemble a control system RTU or gateway in our office. To replicate the fault within our office, we can discover and troubleshoot the problems for our clients. In the following couple of minutes, our senior engineer Carlos gonna run through the step-by-step for troubleshooting the substation gateway.
Here we have an RTU that's used as a gateway for our substation. It's a high voltage, it's up to 20 kV and 33 kV as well. And it essentially this acts as the gateway between the control relays in the substation and the SCADA monitoring. And one of the issues that we encounter is that in this rack, we have a dip switch for setting the rack number. But in this case, this particular model ignores that rack number altogether. So we had to modify our configuration from rack 1 to rack 0. The other issue that we encountered is that the CPUs that we've got, they had different password setups. So we had to harmonize the passwords, that's the technical term. And the other issue was that one of the CPUs had a slightly older firmware, and that would stop all the CPUs from synchronizing. Once we upgraded the firmware of that card, all the other cards synchronized automatically with the primary card. Well, the work we're doing right here is to reduce the risk to the client, make sure that the changes that have been done won't have any impact on the operation of the substation. Ultimately, it comes down to sort of like not just minimizing risk but cost, because risk is expensive.
If you do enjoy watching this video, please subscribe, follow us. If you have any specific technical questions, feel free to give us a call, drop us a comment, send us an email, and we'll be happy to help you out. And overall, we want to help you to understand more about control system SCADA engineering, to equip you with more knowledge from control system engineering industry. Thank you for watching. See you next time.